Don't be stunned by this, but I kickbox and do Brazilian jiu-jitsu, and I'm on the rugby team.
Well, I'm a cyclist.
Taekwondo. I've been practicing it since I was 12.
I'm also a big baker. I like to cook.
I love Irish step dancing. I was an Irish step dancer for 10 years.
I'm a DJ for the campus radio. I play reggae music, which is something you don't hear anywhere.
You know, cycling, I'm looking at what the bikes are made of, what kind of forces they can withstand. And baking, you know, I'm looking at the interaction of the different materials that go into the bread in order to make the final product, which is really a lot like what I do here.
I love playing music, but I also really like engineering and building things.
I love problem solving. I think engineering, it's all about problem solving and how to apply these skills to the real world situations.
When I went to space camp in 6th or 7th grade, that was where I got my first taste of, oh, this is the kind of stuff I can do when I'm older.
Growing up, I've always been interested in math and science. I've always done well in it. And so when I was looking for colleges, people told me to pursue engineering.
Whenever we would drive down a road and I'd see a really cool house, I'd always want to stop and look at it. So that pushed me towards like structures and things.
I realized I really liked construction. This came about when I started doing Habitat for Humanity during high school. I liked being on the work site. I liked getting to see how things start and finish.
I think I've really had engineer in my future my whole life. When I was real little, I was always building. I used to play with Kinects. Those are a great toy.
I was definitely a Legos kid. I liked the Tinker Toys, Legos, anything where you could construct things. You know, I always had these imaginary cities going on.
I always did like playing with Legos.
Legos was the greatest toy I've ever had. Just building and building and building. I guess I liked the building more than I did the destroying, and there's a little saying goes around that everyone's like, oh, mechanical engineers build the rockets and civil engineers build the targets. I was like, oh, I like building the target, I guess.
I really loved the logic behind everything and taking and understanding the world around me and putting it together into something useful and something productive.
Well, I guess one day I was on the driving range for golf and my club literally broke in half. And I had to walk 100 yards out and find it. I'm just kind of curious, well, why did that break today?
Everyone always is like, engineering, oh, that's so scientific and, you know, separated from art. But I couldn't disagree more. I mean, in a sense, I feel as if a mathematician is just as much of an artist as a painter.
I'm studying to be an engineer currently, but my dream job would be to bridge the gap between engineering and developing nations, to bring health technologies or wireless communications to developing nations.
I actually wanted to be a pilot initially, but then it kind of got to me that I was afraid of heights. And I was like, I do like how these machines operate, you know, the thought process that goes into them. I mean, on one hand, you have a piece of metal. On the other hand, you have a plane that can fly, so that whole process, I wanted to be part of that.
I wanted to do something science and math related, but during my senior year, my father was diagnosed with cancer, so I think like that's what particularly drove me in medicine and in bioengineering, because I knew I wanted to make some impact.
Another influence was my dad and my teachers in high school, my science and math teachers. My dad's an engineer too.
I think my brother was a big influence in kind of driving me towards engineering. He's about 8 years older than me. I'm really the baby of my family, and when he went into engineering, I got to see some of the things that he got to deal with, and it really made me want to do that too.
I'm passionate about Lehigh. I love it here. And I don't think that I could have changed this much anywhere else.